August 17, 1942, the Honorable C.D. Howe, Minister of Munitions and Supply, has given approval for funding a nuclear research program in Canada. He ushered in this new atomic era with the simple words, "Okay, let's go."
About working at an atomic pile.
Well, start dreaming about working at a hay pile, because that's what we got right here.
I guess I never told you. I used to be a physics prof in Bratislava, in Slovakia.
Oh, that's why you have a Russian accent.
It's Slovak.
So what are you doing here?
Well, we had to flee the communists, so I came here to Kalabogi to live with Bobby.
Bobby? Is he cute?
Bobby is Slovak word for grandmother.
Oh. Holy wa. So you were a professor there, and now you're here, slinging the hay with us.
I bet you're real smart.
Kind of. And they're building an atomic pile just up the valley in Chalk River, and I wish I could apply for an interview.
A what?
An interview, you know, the thing where they ask you a ton of questions and stare at your chest.
Oh, an interview.
But I can't leave Bobby.
But you gotta go to this pile thingy.
Why? We've got a pile here. We've got a great big pile of shit.
MJ, we have to get back to our pile, but you have to go to that pile.
Yeah, but why do they call it a pile?
Pile is the secret code word for nuclear reactor.
Not much of a secret now, is it?
Why not?
Two reasons. Number one, you just told Bertha here, and she can't keep her mouth shut.
What's the other reason?
I know.
Oh. But how does it work?
Well, first you get one atom to hit another atom, then it breaks into pieces. Then those atoms hit other atoms and break them apart, and so on and so on and so on.
Oh.
Okay, kind of like when I start dating someone else's boyfriend, and then his old girlfriend has to get a new boyfriend and does the same thing, and so on and so on?
Bertha, we're talking about atoms, not atoms.
Oh, Adam. Okay, well, maybe it's more like when my oldest kid smacks the next one down, and then she smacks the one down after that until all five kids are hitting each other.
Yeah, that's it.
That's actually pretty close. It's called splitting the atom.
Well, they should call it splatting the atom.
But the atom splits, that's the point.
But you have to splat it before it splits, right?
Yes.
See, I get it. Maybe they should hire me.
Holy wow.
MJ, you go. I'll take care of your grandma or your babby.
Oh, I don't know. I don't know.
Come on. You go. Go.
What are you, a big fat chicken?
I am not chicken. I would just rather stay here.
Stay here? Liar, liar, pants on fire. Liar, liar, pants on fire.
Okay. Hey, I'll go with you.
Hey, not without me. You'll get too many girlfriend points.
Oh, you can't go. You're a single mom with five kids.
Gee, I missed out on all the fun.
Fun is what got you five kids.
Mm-hmm.
Why don't you go, MJ?
Yeah, I don't know.
You can do it. Go, you're smart. Come on.
Go, MJ.
Go.
MJ.
Come on, I'll watch
Go
Daddy.
Splat Adams. She was a famous physicist from Slovakia. She was bright with the best ideas. She was a prof in a big school. She'd make the other folks look like fools. Everyone around, just wait and see. She's the atom splat physicist from Calabogie. You think that they won't hire you cause you're from the sticks. We know you can make a pile do tricks. They're gonna understand and hire you, cause you're the best in the land. Everyone around, just wait and see. She's the atom splatting physicist from Calabogie. A slap, a smack, a skiddly atom splat, the chain reaction goes on. In boogie rhythm, it's not gonna work unless MJ is working with on. Everyone around, just wait and see. She's the atom splatting physicist from Calabogie. She is the physicist from Calabogie. And when she splats them, they spin like a buzz bee. And when they spin, they splat all the atoms they see. She's the atom splatting physicist from Calabogie. A slap, a smack, a skiddly atom splat, the chain reaction goes on. It's not gonna work unless MJ is working with them. Everyone, just wait and see. She's the atom splatting physicist from Calabogie. I know that I can do it. I have the drive. I've been wanting to do it since I was five. I'll work hard, sort it out. I'll split the atom just like cutting a trout. Everyone around, just wait and see. I'm the atom splatting physicist from Calabogie. Split, splat, splat-a-dee-da-da. Split, splat, splat-a-dee-da-da. Split, splat, splat-a-dee-da-da. Split, splat, splat-a-dee-da. Everyone around, just wait and see. I'm the atom splatting physicist from Calabogie.
Jack, you're late again.
Oh, I'm sorry, Joe.
My kids went crazy. Sybil's losing a tooth. Marlene wanted to practice the piano. And Osana spilled the milk.
My cat, Jack. If you don't get it together,
You're going to be out. But Dr. Cockcroft, surely he knows that I'm a widower with 7 children to look after on my own.
According to him, ZEEP is all you should be looking at.
Oh, but my children, ever since they lost their mother, they're...
They're crazy.
Yeah.
Jack, this is not all right. The only thing that matters is ZEEP.
Tired. You come in late. Your mind's distracted and you can't think straight. Cockcroft watching. You're the one he'll blame. He's watching you. Dr. Feelgood is your name. Jack Feelgood! Jack Feelgood! Why can't you start work on time? You're smart and clever, that's for sure. But you need to work harder or you will be out that door.
Jack Feelgood! Jack Feelgood! Why can't you start work on time? You're smart and clever, that's for sure. But you need to work harder or you will be out that door.
When we stay late, you should too. But you've got to leave because Beanie's got the flu. Cockcroft watching. You've got the lazy frame. He's watching you. Dr. Feelgood is your name.
Jack Feelgood! Jack Feelgood! Why can't you start work on time? You're smart and clever, that's for sure. But you need to work harder or you will be out that door. Jack Feelgood!
My cat, Jack. If you want to keep your job, you better find a way to get in here on time and stay late.
Well, what can I do?
You gotta get a dame to take care of those little electrons of yours. A nanny, a girlfriend, a nun. A hooker, whatever it takes, but you need to do it fast.
I don't want a nanny, a girlfriend, a nun, or a hooker.
Really? Everyone wants a date. Even Leonard's got one.
What do you mean, even Leonard?
Well, I don't care. I've already got 6 girls at the home, and I don't need another one.
Oh.
And don't you go looking for one either for me, Bruno.
Yeah.
Bruno.
Yeah. No nanny, girlfriend, nun, or hooker. Got it.
Waiting for this cockadoodle fella. Why don't you and I work on your interview?
All right.
I've had plenty of experience with my waitress interviews. Here. Let's see what we can use. Okay. Miss Martinovsky, what is your name?
You just told me my name.
Okay, fine, be like that. And while you're at it, maybe undo this top button. He's gonna wanna take a little peek.
Crazy, he's a doctor.
Oh, then he's gonna wanna take a look under the hood too.
Not that kind of doctor.
Okay. Miss Martinovsky, what are your strengths?
I can throw a hay bale onto the wagon with one hand and tie another one with the other.
But can you do it in the pouring rain while I watch?
You pervert!
I'm just trying to be realistic.
What?
Miss Martinovsky, what are your weaknesses?
I have no patience for jerks like you.
Holy why? You gotta be serious. If they ask you for your weaknesses, you gotta think of some that are strengths, like, I'm too much of a perfectionist. Or even better, I never stop until I get the job done.
I can't do this.
Sure you can. It's an interview with a doctor. It's like a checkup.
I hate checkups. Oh. What will this interview be like, I wonder? How will he really be, I wonder? It could be so exciting to work on a pile, you see. My heart should be wildly rejoicing. Oh, what's the matter with me?
You've always longed for adventure, to do the things you've never dared. Now here, you're facing adventure. So why are you so scared? An interview with a doctor.
What's so fearsome about that?
Oh, you must stop these doubts, all these worries. If you don't, I just know you'll turn back. You must dream of the dreams you are seeking.
I am seeking the courage I lack.
The courage to serve them with reliance.
Face all those men without defiance.
Show them you're worthy.
Uranium. I have confidence their trust will be won. I'll make them see I have confidence in me.
Somehow you will impress them. You will be smart and bright.
And all their questions, woof, I'll be ready
to list all of your strengths and weaknesses.
With each step I am more certain.
Everything will turn out fine.
I have confidence the atom will be mine. They'll have to agree. I have confidence in me. I have confidence in fission. Confidence in U-238. I have confidence this pile will be great. Besides which, you see, I have confidence in me.
Strength doesn't lie in science. Strength doesn't lie in math. Strength lies in courage and commitment. When you take charge and be strong.
We can face this task together.
You can do it on your own.
I am confident I don't want to be alone.
I'll go with you. You don't have to be alone.
We'll do it, you see. I'm gonna be sick.
Well, hello. What's your name?
Gracie.
I'm Bruno. Why don't you come outside and we'll get some fresh air and you can tell me all about yourself.
I'm so late. Excuse me, sir, but
Have you seen a physicist?
Hey, what would he look like?
Well, I guess he would be wearing a fedora and carrying a briefcase.
I'm telling you, mister, that's what all them guys look like here. I did not see him.
What about that Bruno fella sniffing around?
Are you looking for Bruno?
No.
No, then I'm telling you, he's not here.
What about them femmes?
They were a couple of crazy dames, just singing and carrying on.
They were drunk. Oh.
Well, I hope he's smart enough to find his own way for the interview this afternoon, then.
Maybe he got cold feet.
How could he? As odd as Ellen here was this fryer going.
Was anyone looking for me?
No, no one looking for Mademoiselle.
Thanks, sir.
Call me Papa Joe. That's what everyone calls me here.
All right, Papa Joe. I guess he's not meeting me here. There's Gracie.
She ran off with Bruno.
Typical.
Oh. Looked like you had a rough day. Pull up a log. My wife will fix you a burger.
Make it yourself. I'm going fishing.
Martinovsky is here for an interview.
All right, Dr. Cockcroft's been expecting him. But you're not MJ Martinovsky.
No, I'm not MJ Martinovsky. She is.
She isn't either.
Holy wow, of course she is.
All right, Dr. Cockcroft's schedule has him interviewing MJ Martinovsky for a physicist position.
Oh, MJ Martinovsky. All right, then.
Whoa, you're not going anywhere. She is a physicist.
Are you sure?
Holy why, I'm sure. Now, can she see this cocktease fella or what?
I'll go see.
You're not going anywhere. We came here to see this cockadoodle fella, and you're going to see him.
You're right. I can do this.
Go ahead.
Nice weather we've been having.
I guess so, if you like it warm and sunny.
Right. Hey, did you hear they have bananas in the grossateria?
Don't eat bananas. I hate foreign food.
Right. Hey, how about them black flies this season?
I don't know. I don't go outside.
Right.
Well...
Don't you have some filing to do or something?
Good idea.
Right. Oh, thank God. Congratulations.
I didn't get the job.
What? Didn't you show him a little bit of...
That was the problem. He thought I was better suited for the stenographer's pool.
But you don't even swim.
Not funny, Gracie. He wanted me to sit mindlessly taking dictation and making coffee. Not that there's anything wrong with that. Nice weather we've been having,
don't,
isn't it?
Don't. All right, well, there's just one thing left to do. I gotta go give this guy peace of my mind.
Gracie, don't.
Don't you want me to give him a piece of my mind?
It's not your mind I'm worried about. It's over, Gracie.
Well, don't worry. I'll think of something.
That's what I'm worried about.
Bye, ma'am. Oh, enjoy the bananas.
There. Wanted immediately. Governess for a widower physicist with 7 children between the ages of 6 and 17. Wait. Seven well-behaved children. To inquire, see Dr. Feelgood at 11 Beach Ave.
But, Bruno, you told him you wouldn't try to find him a dame.
No, I told him I wouldn't try to find him a nanny, a girlfriend, a nun, or a hooker. I didn't say anything about a governess.
True. You're a sly cat, Bruno. But what if that governess turns out to be a hooker?
Then old Jack's gonna have a great time!
Yeah, well, okay.
Wanted immediately. Governess for a widower physicist. I just got you a job.
Why don't you go for that job?
I already have a job.
What? When did that happen?
Over at the train station. I talked with Papa Joe, and I'm a waitress now.
Oh.
Oh, cheer up. You'll get this job. Yep. It's got your name written all over it. Don't you see? He's a physicist. So you can pump this physicist for information while you take care of his kids.
Pump him for information?
His name is Dr. Feelgood. I bet you he feels real good.
You're making that up. It really is Dr. Feelgood.
Look at that. I got you and me a job in less than 24 hours. They say you're the genius.
Let me take Slinky down the stairs!
No!
Why?
Because it's mine! I get to make it walk!
Why?
Hazel! Sybil! You've got to go to bed!
But Daddy, Sybil won't let me take Slinky for a walk!
Because it's mine. I get to play with it whenever I want.
Oh, put Slinky away. It's bedtime.
Slinky doesn't have a bedtime.
Well, I do.
Why?
Because Daddy has to go to sleep.
Why?
Because Daddy has to get up for work tomorrow.
Why?
Oh, because... Oh, now what? Can I help you?
I'm applying to your ad for a governess.
I'm sorry, you must be mistaken. I'm not looking for a governess.
Oh, I'm sorry. I thought this was 11 Beach Avenue.
It is.
Oh, well then, you're looking for a governess.
Wanted immediately. Governess for 7 well-behaved children. Bruno. This isn't my poster.
Are we well behaved, Daddy?
I'm well behaved, and
you're not.
I'm too.
And who want you to be?
I'm Sybil, and I'm the wellest behaved of all.
I'm not. I'm Hazel, and I am.
Is this your comb, Miss?
Oh,
Sybil! How many times have I told you not to take other people's things?
But I always give them back, because I'm a good girl.
I can see you're both good girls.
We are.
And because you're such good girls, you know you should go to bed when Daddy asks you to.
Go to bed, girls.
But I want to stay here with the nice lady.
Oh, well, that's very nice, Hazel. But I'd like to see which one of you can get upstairs and in bed first.
I can!
So, what were you saying about this not being your poster?
I was saying you're hired.
Yes!
Can you start tomorrow?
Yes, I can.
Oh, excellent. Oh, and I didn't catch your name.
Martinovsky. Maria Josefa Martinovsky.
Until tomorrow.
Goodbye.
Maria Josefa Martinovsky. Maria. Maria Josefa Martinovsky. And suddenly it's plain how beautiful a name can be. Maria.
What do you know, Bruno?
What's the scene, Jellybean?
What's the gist, physicist?
That's cute, just like you.
Keep that up, you'll go far. I suppose you'll have burger, fries, and a beer?
How'd you guess?
It's only the same thing you've been ordering the last 3 days. Holy why, you come here a lot.
Only since you started working here.
Cut it out, you're gonna make me blush.
Oh, sorry.
I might turn red, but don't stop.
Something about you, Gracie. I can't take my eyes off you.
It must be this gorgeous uniform.
I heard that. I'll have you know, that uniform is the latest fashion.
Yeah, in the 30s.
I heard that, too.
So, Bruno, you're saying you can't take your eyes off me?
Yeah, I think I'm falling for you.
Quit teasing. You can't be serious.
Why not?
Well, because... You're a physicist with so much fun, with a grand career. I'm a waitress working at the station, serving fries and beer.
At the plans.
need someone older and wiser who knows just what to do.
Ice cream to slow down Benny's temper tantrums?
I don't have temper tantrums!
Kind of. You have to slow the neutrons enough to start a chain reaction.
You're losing me, and I'm real smart, too.
Me, too, and I'm real smart and hurt.
Are not.
Are too.
Are not.
All right. Let's see if I can make it any simpler. Let's start at the very beginning.
A very good place to start.
When you read, you begin with
A, B, C.
With a pile, you begin with uranium.
Uranium.
Uranium. Our compound X just happens to be uranium.
Uranium.
Uranium and heavy water. Let's see if I can make it even easier. Uranium, our favorite atom, atomic number 92. Plutonium, a daughter product, it's an atom that is new.
Moderator.
Come on in, Gracie.
MJ! MJ, Bertha's in trouble.
Oh, no. Is she pregnant again?
Nope, she got kicked out of her house.
What? Why?
Why do you think?
Oh, I don't know. She didn't pay the rent. The kids made too much noise. The neighbors complained.
Yeah, that's pretty much it. Anyway, she needs a place to stay.
All right.
Well...
No! No!
Come on, this house is so big! Jack won't even notice 5 more kids!
What?
They're really little!
And noisy!
Come on, Jack's not around that much, is he?
Well, he is at the plant a lot.
Great!
What?
Come on in, kids!
Welcome. Make yourselves at home.
Wow! Is this a mansion?
Yeah, this house is so big!
Cool stairs. I bet I can run up them faster than you, Mona.
But I can slide down the stairs faster than you, Maury.
Not without messing up your hair.
Hey, wait for me! What are you looking at? I can't see anything.
Come on.
Oh, MJ. Thanks so much for letting us stay here.
Oh, it's no bother at all. I would like to introduce you to Jack's kids, but they just went to the beach.
Get away!
We're back!
What happened?
The black flies were crazy! And I forgot the bug spray!
Me?
Well, who else would it be? Or Santa?
No.
Well, I'm glad you're back. Now I can introduce you to your new friends.
New friends? We don't need new friends. We've got old friends.
They look funny. They smell funny.
Kids, Bertha and her kids are going to be staying with us for a few days. I'll be asking you to make room in your bedrooms for them.
Oh, we can sleep anywhere, like right here on the floor, or in the barn, or wherever.
You're not sleeping in the barn.
Why not?
Because we don't have a barn.
All right. Let's start at the very beginning.
Urania?
Not that beginning. Tell them your names.
Mo!
Well, I'm Etta, and I'm the oldest. I'm a lady now, which means I get to redecorate my room. I'm even getting new curtains. So I can't have one of you dirty kids staying in my room.
New curtains? What are you doing with the old ones?
I don't know. Giving them to the whistle stop or something?
What's the whistle stop?
Some place that hasn't been built yet?
Of course.
I'm Marlene. I'm the nice one. And you guys look really dirty.
I'm Wesley. I don't have any room in my bedroom.
Wait, you have your own room?
We all do.
Really? We just had one room.
You all slept in the same bedroom?
No, the house is just one room. Well, I'm Sybil, and when I'm older, I'm going to be a famous magician. I can make things disappear and then magically reappear. She's a thief. I am not. I always give it back. And I sleep with my dog ZEEP too, so it's pretty squishy in my room.
I'm Ben. Can you guys find Ozzy when I go fishing?
I'm Orsana, and I'm very likable.
I'm Hazel. I'm the youngest, so I have a small bedroom. But I have room for one of you, especially her.
Oh, that's very nice, Hazel.
As long as you scare away the monster out of my bed.
What? Why don't we get you into some clean clothes?
These are only clothes.
We'll have to do something about that. I can sew. I just need to find some material. In the meantime, why don't you tell us your names?
Mo!
Your names can't all be Mo.
They are.
Why are you all called Mo? Because Bertha kept having just one Mo.
There's Maureen. I'm
Mona.
I'm the cutest.
Morag. I'm the toughest. Four-eyed Mo.
I'm robust.
And Monica.
I'm the youngest.
And they're my five kids named
Mo!
Hey, stop pushing me!
Eugene, you're in my spot.
Your spot?
Yeah, that's where I stand.
What's the difference?
Oh, here we go.
What's the difference? That spot is close enough to the radiator to remain warm in the winter, but not so close to cause perspiration. And in the summer, it's situated in the perfect cross breeze by opening windows there and there. And when we're working at the blackboard, it's at the perfect angle not to cause a parallax distortion. I could go on, but I think I made my point very clear.
So do you want me to move?
I thought that was the point I made clear.
Fine. Nut job.
Dr. Wackadoodle.
Mm-hmm. Hey, Jeff, how's things with your house, Dave?
Oh, she's great. The kids love her. Everything is so much easier with her around.
Yeah, but, what do you really know about her?
What do you mean?
Well, has she been asking any questions about our work around here?
She's interested in the work that I do.
And, what's with that sexy Russian accent?
It's Slovakian.
Potato, tomato. Doesn't she seem particularly smart for a woman?
Are you saying that women can't be smart?
Well, I don't hang out with them for their brains.
What are you insinuating?
I think he's insinuating that he uses women for physical gratification. No. I'm insinuating that Jack's Miss Martinovsky may, in fact, be a Russian spy.
She's no spy. In fact, I never would have hired her if you hadn't put the ad up.
Who told you it was me?
You just did.
Oh, yeah.
Could someone answer a question about work?
What? You don't understand that?
No, what does this mean?
Don't be like that guy. He's just new here. What's confusing you?
Why is there polymer on this drawing?
So we can make plastic.
We're making plastic?
Quit it, guys. You cats are not hip. Polymer is our code word for heavy water.
Code word?
Yeah, we don't need our secrets get out to the Russians. Right, Jack?
She's Slovakian!
Don't pay any attention to them. Is there anything else confusing you?
Mm-hmm. What's X?
Well, X is you.
Me?
No, X is you two.
Me too?
No, X is you two three.
Oh, all three of us?
No, let me finish. X is U235.
Yep, on all our drawings, X is uranium.
That's right, and you all know that's what a reactor takes to tangle. U to tango, U to tango, U to 35 or even natural. To the tango, to the tango, uranium is our love. You can heat a house with wood. Gas will start a car, at least it should. Diesel can make a train run. But a pile needs uranium. Cause it takes
you to tango, you to tango, you to 35 or even natural.
Fly a kite.
takes you to tango, you to tango, you to 35 or even natural. Let's do the tango, you to tango. Uranium is our love.
I gotta go to the bank and foreclose and make a deposit.
Well, if you're going, I'm going too.
Oh,
hey, the ladies are having a hen party at my house. Let's crash it.
I gotta stop and pick up a couple train tickets first.
Yeah, I'm working on building my new bendable flashlight.
What's that for?
So I can find my keys when they fall behind the washer.
Does that happen often?
Yeah, more often than you think.
I tell him to put his keys in the keyhole.
Okay, let's go.
Yeah, let's make like neutrons and get the flux out of here. Get the flux out of here.
Yeah, funny. Huh. I'll be there in a little bit, guys. I just want to clean up a few things.
What can I do when I don't know? I'm in love with a guy named Joe. Just one thing I won't lie, he thinks that I'm a guy. But I know, yes, I know, hallelujah, I just love him so. Down, tells me what to do. When I look at him with those eyes, I wanna melt and tell him my lies. Cause I know, yes, I know, hallelujah, I just love him so. If I tell him that I'm a dame, I'll lose my job and fame. But when we're not above, but if I could be in his arms, cause I know, yes, I know, hallelujah, I just love him so. Well, hallelujah, I just love him so.
Hoity-toity ladies over to the house anyway.
It's not just the scientist vibes. I've invited the Stuarts, the Lances, the Blimkies, even the Primos.
The Primos? I can just imagine how well they're going to get along.
We're all women. We all talk about the same things.
Yeah, men. Speaking of men, how's Dr. Feel Good?
More like feel so-so.
So-so good?
No, so-so boring. But he's told me some things about the plant, and now I really want to get in there.
That's easy.
Easy? The place is high security.
They let me in there every night, and all I have to do is clean toilets and empty ashtrays.
Chrissy, why didn't we think of that? I could have got a job as a cleaner. Instead, I'm stuck in this house.
Yeah, poor you. Stuck in this mansion of a house with Dr. Dishy Feelgood walking around in his pink underwear. Oh, poor you, boo-hoo.
Great, Bertha, is there any way you could sneak us in?
Oh, I don't want to get in any trouble.
But there's a way, isn't there?
Oh, well, they let us in every night at 6 o'clock, and there is an extra large cleaning crew coming in this Wednesday to get ready for C.D. Howe's visit.
Who?
No, how.
How? When?
No, how.
I know how, but when?
Who's how?
How's how?
Hold on. C.D. Howe is the Minister of Munitions and Supply. He's the one who approved the nuclear program.
Okay, let's go. We've got lots of ladies coming over, and we haven't even gotten the tea ready yet.
Hey, not so fast. You haven't even told us about that guy you met at the train station.
Oh, Bruno? He's taking me to Boston this weekend.
Sounds serious.
Oh, but make sure he doesn't have any of those STPs. They're really contagious. I know.
Bruno is real special. He's charming, and he's funny, and he's handsome, and he's nice.
He's probably married.
No, I checked.
Sounds way better than Dr. Feel So So.
So, so good.
Will you feed it? Come on, you can tell me more about Bruno while you help me in the kitchen. Oh, Bertha, will you let the ladies in?
Sure.
Thank you.
Hi, welcome.
Hey,
come on in, Mrs.
Pushing me.
Hi.
Hair.
Oh, hello. Oh, hi, welcome. Come on in.
You are pushing me. I
hello.
Know it.
Welcome. Come in. Come in. Hi. Lovely to see you. Wow. Oh, why don't you kids go outside and play with the feel goods and the Mo's?
Yeah.
That's when there's one leg. Oh, it's so wonderful to be here away from that cursed war for. I know why Bruno spends so much time at the plant.
Bruno?
Yeah, that's my husband.
Is your husband married?
Well, he is my husband.
Good.
Why?
I didn't want to get him confused with another Bruno. Gee, it must be a popular name.
You have children, Bertha?
Yeah, five.
What's their father like?
Their father? Let me put it this way. If you eat a can of beans and they make you toot, do you know which bean made you toot?
Well, my Bruno is so amazing. He makes me feel so special. He's charming, he's handsome, he's funny, he's
what?
Smart.
I just met a guy just like that.
Oh, well, hang on to that one.
I will. Just like a good trout, he's a keeper.
I'm not asleep.
A keeper, Edith.
Keeper, is the tea ready?
You're still pushing me. I told you not to touch my skirt.
Can I sit here?
Of course, why not?
Well, there's a spot at our house that Leonard won't let anyone else sit. He's very, very particular.
Is that what you call it?
What are those children wearing?
Oh, my old curtains. Miss Martinovsky sewed them.
I feel like Scarlett O'Hara in Gone with the Wind.
The wind? You kids better close that door. Don't let those bugs in, or I'll put them up each to you.
Oh, yeah, I hate those flies. You know, the black ones?
You mean black flies, dear?
Yes, and there's really little ones, tiny, the size of sand.
Like sand flies, dear.
Did you see a deer?
No,
a deer. A female deer.
Ray,
oh.
Raise your fly swatters, ladies, because I hate all the bugs here.
Ah, you ladies at the town site. You have it so easy. You don't even have to go outside to use the mimic.
Yeah, an inside toilet is a good asset.
Wait, you can go outside here? I thought there were bears.
Oh, there are. My kids love watching them at the dump. It keeps them busy for hours.
You ladies need to learn to appreciate the place.
Flo is right. I've only lived here a year, but I've really grown to love the place.
Life's not a bore in my war for
chop, 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 Chuck River, talk, talk, talk about Chuck River, chop, 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 Chuck River. Life's not a bore in my war for.
I came to the town site in 1945, February minus 35. I thought that I would not survive, but then one night I took a big dive and I learned how to dance the jive. Now I survive with the jive vibe.
Chop, 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 Chuck River, talk, talk, talk about Chuck River, chop, 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 Chuck River. Life's not a bore in my war for. Life's not a bore in my war.
Our dog.
He knows he's no good.
No good? Zeep's a great dog.
No good.
He's not.
Tito, honey. What exactly did Daddy say?
He said that Zeep's no good. He's no good.
I think he probably means it's no good.
Yeah, Zeep's good. He's just got a stupid name.
I wanted to call him Maple. He's sweet like maple syrup.
I wanted to call him Candy, because he can do just about anything.
I wanted to call him Slowpoke, because he's such a slow poke.
I wanted to call him Rex.
Rex?
Yeah, Naughty Rascal Rex, and our Rex.
But Dad said no more fighting, so we'll just call him Z.
And why do you think he chose that name?
Because he was mad at us and he wanted to give him a stupid name?
No. ZEEP is the name of the nuclear reactor your dad is working on. It stands for Zero Energy Experimental Pile. Oh, but don't tell anyone I told you.
Well, I don't understand. And Edith won't remember.
What's that?
Or hear.
So it's not ZEEP no good. That EEP just doesn't work.
Yes, but I think they just have to work some of the bugs out.
Who let those bugs in? Who's town kid?
Uh-oh.
Miss Martinovsky, does Zeep look like this?
Maybe.
And does he sound like this?
Zero energy experimental fire, our heavy water in friend. Zero energy experimental fire, our heavy water in friend.
Help me
ZEEP.
That's a secret, Daddy.
You should sing with us, Daddy.
Yeah.
Reactor, we love you.
Well, you gotta admit, it's catchy.
Oh, you ZEEP reactor, we love you. And our ZEEP reactor loves us too. High power, low power, actually no power on ZEEP, we depend. Zero energy, spare metal pile, our heavy water pottery friend. Zero energy, spare metal pile, our heavy water.
Today, the United States unleashed the atomic bomb on Hiroshima, a Japanese city of 350,000. U.S. President Harry Truman says,
"Having found the bomb, we have used it. We have used it against those who attacked us without warning at Pearl Harbor. We have used it in order to shorten the agony of war, in order to save the lives of thousands and thousands of young Americans. We shall continue to use it until we completely destroy Japan's power to make war. Only a Japanese surrender will stop."
Why does the phone always ring when you're on your way to the bathroom? Hello, Dr. Cockcroft here.
Hello, John. It's Clarence Howe. Sorry to bother you so late. Did I wake you up?
No, I had to get up to answer the phone anyway.
I'm sure you've heard the news about the atomic bomb unleashed by the Americans yesterday.
Of course.
Well, John, don't you feel the sense of urgency?
Well, yes, I do.
Good, because this is a race.
It sure is.
And Prime Minister Mackenzie King wants Canada to be a superpower.
What? Doesn't he know that if Canada becomes a superpower and ruled the world, everyone would be sorry?
I don't follow.
It's a joke, sir, you know, because Canadians always apologize and... never mind.
Yes, well, your scientists contributed to this monumentous achievement by helping with the Manhattan Project.
I'm sorry. Oops, see what I mean?
Sorry? You should feel proud. We Canada are leaders in harnessing the power of the atom. But we can't do it without a nuclear reactor. We can't run a nuclear laboratory without a nuclear reactor.
We're finding that out, sir.
And why isn't this one working?
We're working on it.
Good. Because I'm coming to Chalk River in 4 weeks. And if I don't see that bucket of bolts running, I'm pulling all the funding.
How would you do that?
Correct. I would do that. And there's another thing.
There's more?
Yes. Unfortunately, it seems there's a spy in your midst. The Russians have been found with drawings of the new reactor, NRF. Now, the only way that could happen is if one of your men is irresponsible or a spy. Which is it?
Neither, sir.
Blueberries, ma'am? Secret toy in every cup.
Oh, no, thank you, dear. Hi, Papa Joe.
What you doing here? No suitcase?
I'm meeting my husband, Bruno. He's coming back from Boston.
Bruno, oui, oui. I saw him getting on the train with a very nice app.
Well, you didn't want me to meet him here, but I wanted to surprise him.
Be careful what you wish for.
I'm telling you, he's going to be surprised to see you.
Oh, here comes a train.
Marianne, you can finally meet my boyfriend, Bruno.
Your boyfriend?
That's my husband,
Bruno.
Marianne, I can explain.
This I gotta hear. Oh, you pig! Who do you think you are, Ramon Navarro?
Who is Ramon Navarro?
He is that handsome actor with all the woman hanging off his arm. I can see la resemblance.
The ladies warned me about you, and I didn't believe them. But it was true. All true.
I met you in 1938. I saw you cross the room looking great, but now I see like some other folks do. Get out of here and give me some money too. We had 3 children, life was just so. We're Jill, Tito, and Antonio. But now I see you like some other folks do. Get out of here and give me some money too. I loved you dearly with all my heart, but you went to Boston with that little tart. But now I see you like some other folks do. Get out of here and give me some money too. But now I see you like some other folks do. Like some other folks do.
Ah! Maria, please, wait.
I told her you'd be surprised to see her.
Yep. Might as well go to work then.
That's a good idea.
Blueberries, mister? Secret toy in every cup.
I can't believe they used an atomic bomb on innocent civilians.
Eugene, you're in my spot.
Why don't you make like a fuel rod and Charon cough?
I feel badly that we contributed to it.
What? I mean, what?
Yeah, we helped with the Manhattan Project. The science was so exciting. I never thought it'd be used for something so diabolical.
Yes, it was diabolical.
Yeah. Hey, Bruno. How was your trip to Boston?
It was fantastic. I was with a terrific dame.
Yeah, your wife is pretty great.
It wasn't my wife, Leonard. It was that hot little Gracie, you know, that friend of Jack's delicious governess.
Oh, don't talk about her like that.
Ooh, somebody says it about their house dame.
Oh, she's not my house dame. And anyway, we're talking about your weekend in Boston.
What's to talk about? Took a little trip on the USS Constitution, walked the Freedom Trail, and then I told her I had an interview at Harvard and met up with another dame.
Another dame? Why would you want another lady? Is it one enough?
Oh, Lenny.
Yeah, who do you think you are? Ramon Navarro?
Yeah, I heard things were pretty exciting down at the old train station.
I don't know what you mean.
Yeah, right. My house dame saw Marianne, and she was at the bank, and she was taking out a lot of money, yeah, and heading back to the train station.
Serves you right, Ramon. I would never treat a woman like that.
Because you'll never find a woman.
Well, perhaps you should try and find yours.
Maybe.
Don't pay attention to him, Joe. The right woman will come along.
It's so hard to meet women here.
I know what you mean. I can't find a mistress.
You want a mistress?
Well, yeah, because then I can tell my mistress I'm with my wife, and my wife I'm with my mistress. And then I can stay at work as long as I want!
In private. Okay. So keep this under your fedora. But I got a call from CD Howe last night. It seems like we have a spy in our midst. Ridiculous. Utterly impossible. Well, how would you explain how the Russians got hold of the drawing of NRX? There's a spy in our midst.
That's exactly what I just said.
But I need you to keep a lookout for any strange behavior by the workers. How will I tell? Good point. But be vigilant, Joe, because the security of the nation, maybe even the world, is at stake. All right, sir. All right. Yeah. That's half. Well, now I just need to speak to everyone. Gentlemen! Dr. Kovac wants to talk to you. Gentlemen. Last night I received a call from C.D. Howe.
Who?
No, Howe.
Why?
No, Howe. And he's not amused.
Why? No, Howe.
Will you guys knock it off? Have you men heard about this nuclear bomb that was got detonated on Japan?
What?
What? Oh, come on. It's a legitimate question. Anyway, this bomb has really spurred interest in all things atomic. And so C.D. Howe wants to come here the 1st of September. And he wants to see ZEEP working.
But that's less than a month away and we're still building it.
Well, we better get it built and working. Otherwise, he'll pull all our funding. No more ZEEP. No more NRX. No more town site.
But my children love it here.
Think of the children.
Oh, my humanity.
My grasp was finally starting to grow.
Oh, come on. We're all men here.
Yes, sir.
Sure.
Absolutely. Well, we have the vessel. Mm-hmm. We have heavy water. Mm-hmm. And we have uranium. Yeah. So what are we waiting for?
you need a chain reaction, uranium.
Uranium.
If you want nuclear fission, uranium.
Uranium.
When your neutron isn't so slow, all you gotta do is moderate with D2O. And just that you are A and I U M.
You are A and I U M.
If you want a nuclear pile, uranium. If you need gamma radiation, uranium. If you want that fuel to glow, all you gotta do is moderate with D2O. And just that you are A and I U M. You are A and I U M.
We've got to find Bruno. He needs to know about C.D. Howe's visit.
Well, I'd kind of like to talk to you in private.
Oh, what could be more private than here in front of the post office?
Okay. I'm not quite sure how to tell you this, but what do you know about that dame of yours?
What do you mean?
Well, she has that funny Russian accent.
It's Slovakian.
Whatever. She seems kind of smart for a woman.
Have you been talking to Bruno?
Maybe. At any rate, perhaps you should try and find yourself another nanny. There's a possibility that she could be a...
Bruno! We've been looking for you.
Hey, I've been writing a letter to my lawyer. Marianne cleaned out the bank account and is on the way to Banff with the kids.
Oh, we've got more to worry about. C.D. Howe, phone Dr. Cockcroft.
Howe?
Hmm. Yes, and we've got problems.
We don't get this reactor running by the end of...
It's 1st of September, when he comes for a visit. He's going to kill ZEEP.
And the town site will become a ghost town.
Nothing for it.
Did you hear that? They're gonna kill Z.
But I love Z.
And we'll have to be ghosts.
Can ghosts go fishing?
I don't know.
We've gotta hide Zeep quick.
We need to help.
How can we help? We're just kids.
Well, my mom says two heads are better than one, even if one is a cabbage. So we've got 12 cabbages to figure this out.
We've got to tell Etta. She'll figure something out.
That's what I'm afraid of.
Thank you.
Okay, everybody, just do as I tell you and nobody gets hurt.
Get hurt? You never said anything about getting hurt.
I don't want to get hurt.
I don't want to break a nail.
Who's going to hurt us? I'll take care of them. Me. If you don't be quiet and do as I tell you.
Don't pull, don't pull.
Whoa. Check this place out. That must be ZEEP.
Oh, wow, this must be where we go fishing.
Did you hear that?
What?
I don't know. A noise?
What if it's Dave Cox and he catches us here?
I'll take care of him, too. No one's going to catch us here.
Why?
Because no one ever catches us.
But Dad caught us singing about ZEEP.
Yeah. What are we going to do if we get caught? We need a plan.
I've got a plan. Did you honestly think I'd bring you in here without a plan?
Yes!
Well, listen. Walking about and comes up to the pile just checking it out. If he hears us and shouts, hey, hey, don't be afraid, this is what we'll say. There ain't nobody here but us cleaners. There ain't nobody here at all. You keep stomping around and clomping around and kicking up an awful dust. We clean and try to clean and you we meet and stomp, stomp, stomp with your dirty feet. There ain't nobody here but us. There ain't nobody here at all. So quiet yourself and stop that fuss. There ain't nobody here but us. Point that camera gun the other way and hobble, hobble, hobble up in the hay.
Tomorrow
it's a busy day.
Got things to do.
No time to play.
I've got to shine.
For the wax.
Now it's coming and that's a fact.
Oh, there ain't nobody here but us. There ain't nobody here at all. You keep stomping around and clomping around and kicking up an awful dust. We clean and try to clean and you we meet and stomp, stomp, stomp with your dirty feet.
Who are all these people? I've never seen so many cleaners. They all look small enough to be your kids. Wait a minute, they are my kids.
I'm the feel-good kids.
They're in trouble.
There ain't nobody here but us. Cleaners. There ain't nobody here at all. So quiet yourself and stop that fuss. There ain't nobody here but us. Point that camera gun the other way and hobble, hobble, hobble up and hit the hay. Hey kids, what do you say?
Don't be a wiener. There ain't nobody here but us cleaners.
We're just cleaning, sir.
Yep, waxing the floors and such.
Yeah, we want things to be sparkling when Doctor Who gets here.
How?
I don't know.
Cleaning. Very well, then. Use your inventory tools. Don't forget to hold the handrail.
Yes, sir!
Okay, cats, we gotta get this pile going tonight.
Oh, how are we gonna do that?
Oh, the Toronto Maple Leafs won the Stanley Cup this year. Anything's possible.
You can't stand there.
Why not?
That's his spot.
What's the difference?
Let's see. It's close enough to the radiator to remain warm in the winter, but not so close that he sweats. In the summer, it's situated in the cross breeze by opening windows there and there. And when we're working at the blackboard, it's at the perfect angle, not to cause distortion.
There's hope for you yet.
Sorry, sir. I just want to clean off the blackboard before.
No! No!
And where are your DLD badges?
Badges? We don't need no stinking badges!
On that thought, just go clean somewhere else. Your plan.
Oh. Okay, let's fire it up.
Don't you think Dr. Cockcroft should be here for this?
Well, I'd kind of like to see that it works before Dr. Cockcroft sees it doesn't.
I guess that makes sense.
Yeah. What's the worst that could happen?
Actually, not a bad idea. All right, let's get ready.
Rope! I'm ready!
Leonard, you watch that level. Jack, keep your eyes on those criticality monitors. They're your design. You know them best.
Right.
Walter, you got the pressure?
Yes, sir.
Bruno, monitor this temperature.
Right.
All the way. All right. Eugene, raise the heavy water. I mean the polymer.
Yes, Joe.
yes, sir. Raising.
I'm going to try.
Anything yet?
No, nothing.
And it's on.
Now?
No.
Nine.
Now?
No, nothing.
Buffett, good boy.
Watch the needle, kids.
Can't see it.
Go closer.
Now?
No. Hey, what are you doing?
Cleaning the glass.
Cleaning the glass now?
Now?
Now? No.
All right, Eugene. Dump the moderator.
You mean the polymer?
Maybe.
Okay.
How come no one else saw it move? Yeah, that's it.
Are you sure?
Yep.
We gotta tell somebody. But who?
We can't tell Dad. He'd kill us.
Miss Martinovsky. She won't be mad. She might even be happy.
Yeah.
Okay, cats. I guess it's black. Board time.
Right. Now I'm in my spot. But... I can't get no chain reaction. I can't get no chain reaction, but I try, and I try, and I try, and I try. I can't get me no, no, I can't get me no. When we pump in D2O, watch the level go up so, so, so. Neutron should bombard, hit an atom but not hard, and split it wide apart.
You're not going anywhere.
Are we in trouble?
Holy why, you are!
Uh-oh.
Well, we need to talk to you, too. Yeah, that ZEEP thingy works. Or I Mo saw it. Tell her, Mo.
Go ahead. It moved.
What moved, Holly? Are you sure, son? I didn't see it move. You were there!
Oops. Did I like keep my cleaner's outfit?
Oh, brother. What did you see, Mo?
Well, I couldn't see on account of my bad eyes. So I went up real close to the monitor, and I saw it. Then when the funny-looking guy with the polymer out, the needle went down.
Are you sure?
Yes.
It works. It works! It really works!
You ZEEP reactor, ZEEP reactor, we love you. And our ZEEP reactor, ZEEP reactor, loves us too. High power, low power, actually no power, on ZEEP we depend. Zero to G experiments apply, I love everyone, moderate and friend. Zero to G experiments apply, I love everyone, moderate and
friend. What's going on here?
It works. It works.
What works?
ZEEP.
What are you talking about?
Four-eyed Mo saw the needle move.
Who? What are you doing here?
Me too.
Me too.
What?
Me too. Aren't I cute?
What are all these children doing living in my house? And why are they all dressed in Etta's curtains?
Well, it's
And four-eyed Mo saw the needle move? Wait a minute. You kids were all those cleaners. And you. You were the one who was cleaning the glass on the gauge. And you were there too. You and that funny mustache. Oh, get out. Get out, all of you!
No!
Not you, Miss Martinovsky.
Licker! Jack, Four Eyes saw the needle move. ZEEP works.
Oh, great. So I'm going to tell CD Howe that the reactor works, but only a nearsighted 8-year-old can tell.
There must be something wrong with the instrument. Who designed that piece of junk?
I did.
Oh.
Ben, we'll make it work better.
Oh, great. And how are we going to do that before tomorrow?
You don't do it. We do it. Together.
Oh, right. A governess is going to help me save the plot.
Like Bertha says, two heads are better than one, even if one is a cabbage.
Oh, this is serious? They think you're a spy. They want me to kick you out of this house and... I couldn't bear that.
What?
Oh, they think you're a spy.
After that?
Oh, they want me to kick you out of the house.
After that?
Oh, but I couldn't bear that.
Really?
Oh, yeah, the children have grown quite fond of you.
Just the children?
Oh, I should be so furious with you. But... But the children are happy. I'm happy. Happier than I've been since, well, for a long time.
I'm happy too.
Oh, MJ, you've helped me realize what a wonderful place this is. I see white pine trees. I see the river wide.
What a wonderful place. The color of blue, so pretty in the skies, reminds me of the color of your loving eyes. I hear my children laugh with glee, 'cause they love you and me.
I hear your voice, soft yet strong, and I know it's here I belong. And I think to myself, what a wonderful place.
Come over tonight.
Well, the men are all at the plant mooning over C.D. Howe. There's really nothing else to do.
Nothing to do? I was running around like crazy trying to find a pair of gloves for Leonard to wear. He was so afraid he was going to have to shake hands with C.D. Howe.
Miss Martinovsky?
Yes?
Can we do a play for you and your friend?
Ladies, are you up for some entertainment from the children?
Oh, I'm up for anything.
Yeah. Oh, I love plays!
What? Are we going to play?
I love you, girl.
How do you ever remember what suit is Trump?
What? Not President Truman is.
Oh, itty. No, like that the picture shows.
Who's got the popcorn?
All right, Hazel, we're in.
Wait. Hey, kids, we can do it!
Come on, Danny!
Yay!
Loudly he sang like Bing the Cooner.
In the town under the moon heard, blushing clear later or sooner.
Oh, how hooty hooty hoop hoop. Oh, how hooty hooty hoop. Oh, answered back to the lonely lunar.
To mama, wishing on the moon heard.
Hooty, 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 hoo.
They should be wed later or sooner.
Hooty, hooty, hoo. Happy are they. Hooty, hoo, hooty, hoo, hoo. Oh, hooty, hoo, hooty, hoo, hoo, hoo. Soon the duet will become a trio.
Oh, I
that look means.
I've got a parcel to mail.
Not without me, you don't.
Me too.
But it's 8 o'clock at night. Overnight delivery.
Excuse me, ma'am. Is this your compact?
Oh, yes, it is. Thank you.
Dear.
Sybil, you know you're not supposed to be taking other people's things.
But I always give them back.
Mommy's uniform is gone.
They've gone to the plant again.
But, Dee Dee, how will be there?
And so will I!
Come on, Edie.
Seedy, is it time for seating already?
No, come.
What about us?
No! Well, what are we waiting for?
Okay, let's go!
Mr. Howe, welcome to our state-of-the-art facility.
Am I supposed to be taking notes?
Yes.
Oh, all right.
So, this is ZEEP.
Yes, the Zero Energy Experimental Pile.
And you're going to start it up tonight.
That's correct, isn't it, Joe?
That's the theory.
Well, as we raise the level of the polymer in the vessel, the moderator will reach a level where we will achieve a chain reaction. At that point, the needle on that gauge should start to rise, indicating that the reactor is working and has gone critical.
I see.
This is so exciting. No one's ever let me do anything this exciting before. Aren't you excited?
So excited.
Keep your eyes on that dial. Okay, let's go.
Hey, that's my line.
The needle and that gauge should start to move anytime now.
It's not moving.
Be patient.
Really patient.
It's not moving! Anytime now! It's not moving! Now? It's not moving! This bucket of bolts doesn't work!
Wait, sir, just give it time! I've given it 3 years! How much time do you want?
Well, just a bit more.
Jack, what are the cleaners doing here?
What? I told them, Jane.
No. What?
Oh, I'm old and jaded.
Jack.
I think that cleaner is trying to get your attention.
Maybe I've left a muddy footprint in the hallway or something.
Yeah.
What?
Shadow puppets.
No, shadow puppets, this isn't the time we cannot...
Shadow puppets.
Shadow puppets. Shadow puppets. MJ, you're a genius. Oh, Dr. Cockcroft, we're going to try something.
Anything, just hurry.
That's it. I've had it. We've wasted enough money on this. No longer will I put up with this. From now on, I'm out of here.
Where are we going, sir?
We're going to the byways.
Is it critical?
Absolutely critical. Except this reactor.
Wait.
wait.
Crazy Bertha, distract him.
We're on it. Well, hello, sailor.
Hello, ladies.
You know, when they said we'd be cleaning for some big shot governmental fella, they didn't tell us he'd be so handsome.
Gracie?
Pay no attention to him.
We only have eyes for you, Doctor Who.
Hurry up! We haven't much time.
Are you kidding? Gracie and Bertha can keep him distracted for hours.
Okay, we're ready, sir. Oh, Mr. Howe, Mr. Howe, if you can focus your attention on the screen.
I'm busy, John. Don't bother me.
Gracie, Bertha, off.
Well, I've got a toilet to clean.
And I've got to clean the brush.
Watch that dial. Are we ready?
Ready, sir. Okay. Hit the lights. All right, Eugene. Raise the level of the polymer one more time.
Raising.
Look, it's moving. By Jove.
Now that we've accomplished it, we'll start to gain some traction. If you understand it, you are in a dirty faction. Supercritical atomic suspension reaction.
I didn't know quite why. I thought nuclear beating, and that is not a lie. But now that I have seen ZEEP running at full force, I'll continue funding for NRX, of course.
Supercritical atomic sustained chain reaction. Now that we've accomplished it, we'll start to gain some traction. If you understand it, you are in the nerdy faction. Supercritical atomic sustained chain reaction.
So when you think things won't work out, there's no need to despair. Just put a couple rods real close and you'll be on your way. This little ZEEP reactor will change everyone's life.
For example?
It makes me so happy. I'm ready to ask. Will you be my wife? Yes?
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 Yes!
Yay! Supercritical atomic sustained chain reaction. Supercritical atomic sustained chain reaction.
Supercritical atomic sustained chain reaction.
Supercritical atomic sustained chain reaction.
I know I'd rather be fishing than wearing lipstick, but here I am.
Réjeanne, have you seen my wedding leash?
Your wedding, the Sunday tie, will do just fine.
Mama, do I really have to wear this dress? How tight and itchy.
Well, Ben's the only one you have. You can't go to the wedding wearing your school clothes.
She gets my school clothes. I'm not going to. Short pants.
And I'm not wearing a cravat.
If I have to wear lipstick, you are going to wear those short pants, you are going to wear that cravat, and you are going to wear that tight, itchy dress.
But, Mama!
Oh, we can't go now. The train is coming in.
Who's going to the station? Everyone will be at the wedding.
Oh, madame, look like you had a rough trip. Sit and my wife will fix you a burger.
I will not, you fool. We're going to be late for the wedding.
Oh, don't worry. We're going to the wedding, too.
Mommy, will Daddy be at the wedding?
I suppose so.
Then after the wedding, we'll go back to Daddy.
No, dear. We'll go to the wedding, pick up a few things, then we'll go back to bed.
But I like it here.
Yeah, why can't we stay here with Daddy?
Because your father is a... Your father is, how can I put this? What animal goes oink, oink, oink?
A pig!
Exactly.
Badges?
Badges? We don't need no stinking badges.
But what are you charging her with?
That is top secret.
Is that a secret, or do you just not know?
It's top secret. That's why I don't know.
Of course you know. You just don't remember.
Okay, you're right. It's top secret because, oh, I don't remember.
Oh, for Pete's sake. This woman, Maria Josepha Martin Whatevsky, is a Russian spy.
What? What?
Did she or did she not first move into your house in June?
Yes.
Well, that is when information started being leaked.
Ah, that's just a coincidence.
Has she or has she not been asking questions about this
pile thingy?
Well, yes, but...
And does she not have a Russian accent?
It's all right here!
Check.
No. Slovakian.
Has she or has she not been on the plant on at least one occasion?
Well, yes, but...
She is a double-crossing, double-jointed, Timmy's double-double, double agent.
You can't speak about my friend like that. She's an amazing Adam Splatton physicist. She was even a phys ed prof in Bratislava, and she's real smart, too.
Berta, honey, you're not really helping.
You're a physicist?
That's where I remember her from. The interview.
Aha.
What do you mean, aha?
Well, everybody knows that ladies can't be physicists.
Oh, what about Madame Marie Curie?
Yeah.
Never heard of her. Name another one.
Lee Smeichner.
Mm. Nope.
Harriet Brooks?
Who?
Yeah.
Hedy Lamarr.
I know her. She's an actress.
And a physicist. Google it.
Oh. Look, name a female physicist that we've actually heard of. See? I told you, Miss Martin, whatever, Ski, you are under arrest.
Wait, wait, wait. I'm a woman.
You're a woman?
You're a woman.
You're a woman.
I've been pretending to be a man so I could work on ZEEP.
You know what? Me too. What? I'm a woman too.
I didn't realize that I had so many lady physicists working for me.
This changes nothing. Miss Martin Whateversky, you are still under arrest for espionage. Handcuff her.
What?
MJ, you need a lawyer.
Do you know someone?
Maybe. Oh, MJ, I'm so sorry. If I hadn't gotten you into all this mess, none of this would have happened.
Are you kidding? If you hadn't convinced me to come to Chalk River, they'd still think ZEEP doesn't work. Hey. And I wouldn't be marrying Jack today.
You're not. There won't be any wedding. I can't marry someone who's going to jail.
Oh, why not?
The handcuffs, they get in the way.
But can't there still be a wedding?
Very true.
Oh! Not them. Eugene.
Oh. It's actually Jeannie.
Jeannie, would you marry me?
Yes, yes, yes! On one condition.
Oh, what's that?
That you let me keep working as a physicist.
Oh, well, I can't imagine you doing anything else.
Oh. Hey, Mr. Pontecorvo, is this yours?
What's this?
I don't know.
Wait a second, let me see that. This is a drawing of NRX. And it's addressed to the Kremlin.
Where did you find this young lady?
In Mr. Pontecorvo's briefcase. Am I in trouble?
Oh, you're so not in trouble, lassie.
Well, don't just stand there. Arrest him.
Wait, 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 wait. I have horrible handwriting. It doesn't say Kremlin. It says gremlins. I was checking the design for gremlins.
All right, I've heard enough.
Wait. Could be right. I remember watching a movie about the gremlins.
Oh, you didn't? This is 1945, not 1985.
Remove the handcuffs from her and put them on him.
Daddy!
Oh, no, 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 wait! Bruno, I'll take you back.
Really?
Let's be a family again.
I promise, I'll always be true to you.
Oh, I love you.
So, can we get married now?
Ah, why not?
And us too?
I don't see why not.
Yarrie.
Okay, let's go. These will be the first two weddings conducted at the town site.
Town site. Can't we give it a name?
Yeah. Town site's not very romantic sounding.
Oh, well, the natives call it the Kitchissippi River.
Kitchissippi!
Well, I'm telling you, les voyageurs called la rivière Ir la rivière Creuse.
Hmm. I like to cruise down the river.
You Anglophone, cruise is the French word for dig because the river digs deep.
Oh, I dig that.
Ah, the river here is very deep. Deep river's a great name.
La Rivière Creuse is a great name. Deep river, that sounds silly.
Yeah, and you know if they call it Deep River, two fools are going to climb up the water tower with a can of paint and change it to Beer River.
Deep River it is, then.
Huh?
Deep River.
Deep River!
Deep River!